Dear brothers and sisters, my name is Ricardo Rossi. I was born in Guayaquil, Ecuador, South America. I am 52 years old, and I currently live and work in Louisville, Texas. I work as a security professional at Vista Ridge Mall. If you have visited that area, you probably had seen me there in the mornings. I was born and raised Catholic by my grandparents. I guess you can say Christ has always been in my life. But the problem was that for many years I was in the wrong church. As I got older, my relationship with Jesus Christ grew tremendously. I have always tried to live for Him. I'm not perfect. And I never will be. But God loves me. He's there when I stray. I know that I'm a sinner. And because God has taken away my sins, I'm getting baptized today. I became a believer and follower of Jesus Christ through my dear wife, Miriam Rossi. She taught me that if I accept Jesus Christ as my Savior, I will have a new life, and that Jesus Christ will be watching over me, protecting me, molding and shaping me in the better follower of Christ. My decision to accept Jesus Christ as my Savior has made me a better person in Christ and to understand more about the alliance with God. Once, I was a person sick with diabetes type 2. My wife, Miriam, prayed for me day and night. During the fasting days in the days in the Christian and Missionary Alliance Church in Guayaquil, Ecuador, she prayed and prayed for me day and night. She knew deep inside her heart that Jesus Christ will take care and heal me. Jesus Christ was with me in my time of sickness, and through prayer I was healed. I am so grateful to my wife Miriam for teaching me to believe in God and to teach me how to pray. I am so grateful to God for giving me a church, His church, filled with prayer warriors like my wife Miriam, who pray for me day and night. I really learned to trust Jesus Christ and how to give it all to Him. Having a relationship with Him has turned my life's challenges into life lessons. Now I am diabetes free. Jesus has given me hope in my future. And I'm being baptized today because I believe that Jesus Christ is my Savior. I look forward to continue building my life on the solid foundation that is Jesus Christ, my rock and salvation. Amen.
Hello everyone, my name is Janet Fan. I want to thank Brother Shikong and Sister Hu, Sister Ian, and for her bringing me here today to be baptized. Of course, I have to thank my husband and also my two daughters. It's their relationship with Christ and their love for Christ, their perseverance praying for me that has brought me here today. And so as I started, let me tell you my story. But So it was my dependence on the Lord and His Holy Spirit that led me here today.
我在1995年就知道耶稣与十字架的关系。
And in 1995, I heard the story of the cross and about Jesus.
因为我先生是一个基督徒。
And because my husband was a Christian.
而且我也很快接受耶稣是我的救主。
So I quickly also accepted Jesus as my Savior.
理由很简单。
The reason was very simple.
因为我死后我想上天堂，不想下地狱。
Because I wanted to go to heaven, I didn't want to go to hell.
但这些并没有与我的心发生关系。
But this wasn't the major change in my life.
想上天堂，但没有清楚罪的问题。
So I wanted to go to heaven, but I didn't understand the wages of sin.
常常自作主张，没有让耶稣基督做我生命的主。
So I still, through that, I did not let Jesus really be Lord of my life as my Savior.
2013年我来到了咱们的教会。
And 2013, I started coming to church again.
参加了由关世康弟兄和王文宝弟兄带领的基要真理主日学。
And I attended Brother Shikong and another person's cell group here to study the Bible.
在主日学班上，我记得世康弟兄问我们的第一句话是：“你有罪吗？”
I remember Brother Shikong's first question was in that class. He asked the students, "Do you all have sin?"
我又没犯法，何罪之有？
Did you? One more time, please.
我又没犯法。 Not against the law.
Oh, yes. Did you break the law or did you offend God in a way, a sin?
但是通过在主日学和小组的一段时间的学习,
and after going through a period of time in the cell group, this Bible study,
我承认我是个罪人,
I admitted that, yes, I am a sinner.
并且在主日学班上做了认罪决志祷告,
and then in that class, I prayed the sinner's prayer.
相信神是信实的, 必要赦免我的罪, 洗净我一切的不义。
I know that Jesus is my Lord and Savior, and that He, I wanted Him to cleanse me of my sin.
我的属灵新生命才开始萌芽。
And at that point, my spiritual life started to grow.
其实我还是有很多不懂的地方。
There are many other things that I still don't understand.
但是我带着信心跨出了第一步，来到了主的恩典里面来，因为我需要。
But this was part of my first step in faith in also knowing God more.
我需要神的恩典，因为我生命里有一个我无法解决的问题。
And I am really in desperate need of God's grace because there are some areas in my life that I need to change.
就是罪。
Which is the sin.
而且影响我得永生。
And also the need for to have eternal life as well.
耶稣说，我是世界的光，跟从我的就不在黑暗里走，必要得着生命的光。
And Jesus said that I am the light of the world. Whoever walks with me walks in the light and not in darkness.
神是无所不知的，在主的带领下，我现在会诚实地面对自己。
Now with the Lord's help, I can face the sin in my life and move forward.
知道我生命里有黑暗的存在。
I know that there is still darkness, there's still sin in my life.
那些黑暗可能是抱怨、怨恨、撒谎。
I still have anger, I still have bitterness, still some envy.
而且我以前根本不知道这是我的罪。
And before, I didn't even realize that these were things I struggled with.
但是在正直、公义、独一真神面前，我必须承认我已经得罪了神。
But when I realized that this sin was in my life, I realized that I needed to confess and I can bring this before the Lord.
因为圣经说，世人都犯了罪，亏缺了神的荣耀。
Because in the Bible it says that we have all sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
自从来到美国以后,
and when I've come to America,
我每天都很忙,
I was very busy.
学习忙，工作忙，家庭忙。
Learning, working, busy with family.
在我最忙碌的时候, 情绪总会受到影响。
And of course, you know, in the times that I was most busy, you know, my mood would be affected by this.
脾气变得暴躁，经常抱怨。
Would get very angry, would complain a lot.
影响了家庭的生活。
And that would affect my family.
以前我先生经常跟我的两个孩子说,
and in fact, my husband used to tell my two daughters,
跟你妈妈讲话就像跟中国的警察讲话。
My husband told my two daughters, talking to your mom is kind of like talking to the police in China.
我以为那是我的性格,
and I thought maybe this is just who I am, my personality, and I can't change that.
但当我认识主以后,
but after I met Christ,
我的脾气变了好多了,抱怨也少了。
I started complaining less, my temper got a lot better, my attitude changed.
腓立比书第二章14节说,
Philippians 2:14 says,
凡所行的都不用发怨言,起争论。
Do everything without complaining or arguing.
这句话帮助了我很多。
This has helped sustain me in my life.
自从行在主的道路上,我开始认识到。
As I started walking more with the Lord,
对相信和束缚上帝的人而言,
after believing the Lord and following Him,
只要合乎他的旨意,没有不可能的事。
As long as I follow His will and direction, nothing is impossible.
甚至可以没有负面影响。
In fact, one more time.
没有负面的情绪。
Nothing is impossible, and there's nothing that can't be done. Nothing.
所以我会常常来到神的面前，寻求他的旨意。
So I'll always come before God, and I'll ask Him for His help.
在越忙的时候，越花时间来祷告和亲近上帝。
In fact, the busier that I am, I realize the more that I need God, the more I need to come to Him.
让我的心灵在面对忙碌时得到平静，变得善良、喜乐。
And before Him, before God, I can get more peace, and I become more calm inside and happier as well.
我发现祷告以后就有智慧和判断力。
And after prayer, I start gaining wisdom. I start having that knowledge to know what to do.
知道哪些事情可以做，哪些事情不可以做。
Knowing which things that I can do, which things that I shouldn't do, or which things I don't need to do.
我的体会是遇到事情先静下来求神。
Okay, and so I realized that when I face different things in my life, I come to God and I ask Him for help.
还有什么比神更可靠的呢？
And if this is my God who can do this for me, then what can't He do?
还有什么比他更有能力的呢?
Is there a God that is stronger, better than Him?
还有什么比他更有办法呢?
Is there a God that's more capable, anyone that's more capable than Him?
天地万物都是他造的。
He's created everything here.
我的生命、呼吸、存留都在他手中。
My breath, my life, it's because of Him.
我有什么理由不相信上帝、不跟随他呢?
So what reason do I have not to believe in Him, not to follow Him?
感谢主解决了我。
Thanks to God for saving me and for redeeming me.
今天受洗只是开始。
Today the baptism is just the beginning.
求主保守我的信心, 坚定地跟从主, 做耶稣基督的门徒。
And I pray that He'll continue to help me grow my faith as I follow Him and become His disciple.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi,
my name is Catherine Young.
蒙慈爱的主的恩典，今天我在这里受洗。
Very thankful to God because of His grace and compassion that I'm here today.
归入主的名下。
That under Him.
做主的儿女。
That I am now His daughter.
我心里感到非常的高兴，激动。
Very happy to be here today. Very emotional.
更多的是一种心情的平和。 和内心的喜乐。
Very peaceful and happy inside.
在这里我跟大家分享一下我信主的经历。
And I wanted to share a little bit of how Christ has changed me.
感谢主的带领，我在2014年的时候参加教会的学生团契。
So in 2004, I attended a student Christian fellowship here.
后来因为各种原因就没有继续。
However, some reasons I didn't attend anymore.
直到2016年的夏季音乐会的时候，我和我的一位已经信主的朋友来听音乐会。So
in 2006, I attended a concert here, and I went with one of my friends, and I really enjoyed that experience.
那个时候，我被音乐会的气氛所感染，在翠莹姐妹的带领下，我决志信主。
So at that concert in 2006, my friend, oh, 2016. Oh, sorry, 2014, 2016. Sorry, I heard wrong. So my friend led me to the concert. I really felt moved by that, and I accepted the Lord.
从那个时候，我开始更多的加入团契，并且学习圣经。
And at that point, I started attending fellowship more, and I started studying the Bible more.
恰逢那个时候是在临近毕业的时候，面临很多留学生都会面临的问题。
So at that time, when I was about to graduate, a lot of the foreign students, you know, they're facing a lot of decisions, a lot of difficulties.
是留在美国呢，还是回中国大陆？
And the main problem is, do I stay here in America or do I go back to China?
很长一段时间我都非常的苦闷，也是那个时候我开始默默的向神开始祷告。
So at that time, you know, it was kind of hard for me, but I started to pray more.
感谢主，我在这里找到了一份工作，并决定留在美国。
And thanks be to God that I actually found work here and wanted to stay here in America.
因为我办理EAD卡的时间比较迟，我等了两个半月还没有收到，那个时候我感觉非常的焦虑。
So there was a period of time, about 2.5 years, I was waiting to get a job.
2.5 months.
Oh, month, yeah. 2.5 months. And yeah, I was looking for a job and I didn't get a job, so I was a little bit worried.
EAD
oh, the EAD, the Employment Authorization Card.
我记得我坐在车里默默地祷告，说主啊，既然你已经让我留在了美国，请你让我尽快地开始工作吧。
So as I actually was wondering, waiting for this card, I said, well, Lord, you already have me here in America, so what about my work? Is that going to work out for me?
然后我在车里给USCIS打了电话，预约第二天早上6点去Irving的移民局。
So I called the immigration office, and 2 days later?
Yeah, just in the car.
Just in the car.
Yeah.
And I went to the Irving office.
没想到那个时候办公人员说，昨天就已经将我的卡片寄出了。
Oh, so when I went to the office, and actually they told me that my card was approved, and they're already sending it to me.
很神奇吧。
So that was just wonderful. How wonderful was that to get the card?
还有一件事，就是在我周天从教会回去的路上。
And there was another incident as I was coming, going back home from church.
我知道我的轮胎的灯亮了，但是我当时只是以为没气了。
So I saw my tire pressure light come on, or my tire light. I thought maybe it was just the pressure.
所以我打算一路狂奔回家再打气。
So I thought, well, maybe I can make it home and then I can put some more pressure in my car.
当我看到灯亮的时候，我就开始祷告，主啊，你一定要让我安全的回家。So
when I saw the light, I started praying. I said, Lord, please bring me home safely.
在我当要打转向灯上高速的那一瞬间，我的车胎爆了。So
actually, as I was on the road, I think about to get on the highway, my tire burst.
虽然我的车胎爆了，但是那一瞬间我感觉到了，其实还是有一些幸运的。And
so even though my tire burst, I actually still felt
lucky.
Oh, still felt lucky. Still felt like something was going on.
因为当我打了应急灯之后，后面的车并没有撞上来。And
even though the light came on, fortunately, no cars came and hit me from behind or hit me.
而且如果我要是当时是在高速上面爆掉的话，车爆掉的话，可能我就会发生车祸。So
thankfully, I wasn't already on the highway, and I wasn't going. Otherwise, it would have been very bad.
很幸运，我很快就 pull over， 找到了小伙伴帮我换轮胎。
So I was able to actually pull over, and there was someone that helped me
to
change the tire.
在那一瞬间，我觉得一定是上帝听到了我祷告，在守护着我。
So this has to be, this incident had to be the Lord watching and listening to my prayer.
还有一点让我非常感谢主的是，之前我的父母，尤其是我的父亲， 对我来教会的事情持有一定的反对意见。
So there's another instance I want to share. My parents actually were against me coming to church.
但是自从他来过教会之后，他发现我身上出现发生了一些改变，他感到非常的开心。
So after seeing me come to church, they saw my attitude change and saw me more at peace, happier.
他现在非常支持我这个决定。And
now they are supportive of me going to church.
我是一个信心很不足的人，同时也很容易起疑心。
And actually, a lot of my faith can be lacking. Is that one more?
Suspicious.
Oh, suspicious, yes.
但是我并不质疑上帝，我知道他是真实存在的。
But I do know that our Lord is real and that He is faithful.
他带给我信心，让我不再软弱。
And He guards me even in my weakness.
天上的父啊，我知道这一切都是你的安排。如果这是你为我安排的路，我愿坚定不移地走下去。谢谢。
And our Heavenly Father, I know that when He watches my path, I will follow that path, and He will lead me wherever I go. Hi, brothers and sisters. My name is Geng Li.
Yeah.感谢神的安排，让我今天站在这里接受神的爱。
Thank you for this opportunity that I'm here to accept God's love.
和神的恩典。
And His grace.
我一直是个充满敬畏的人，相信一切事情在冥冥之中自有天意。
I'm always a person that believes that things can happen for a reason.
任何事情的发生都是有一双看不见的手所安排。
And behind these things, someone is working. There's something happening.
但是我之前一直愚钝，不知道这双手属于谁。
But before my life, I didn't know who was behind this, what caused this.
直到我快要升学考试时。
And as I was about to graduate, said? taking a test.
Yeah. 一切都发生了改变。
I started to change.
我当时学业遇到了问题。主要是沉迷于网络游戏。
I had a problem, and that was I love playing video games.
想考上好的学校非常困难。
And of course, getting into a good school made it very difficult.
不幸的是，当时处于青春的叛逆期。
Over time, sir.
青春期叛逆。
Oh, okay, okay. Was it winter? 你说青春 ？Oh.
青春期。
Oh, yeah, yeah, sorry. Okay. Yeah, so it was obviously my parents weren't very happy with that, and it was against what they wanted too as well.
Against their idea.
And he was, he was against their, against what they wanted for me. He was kind of rebellious.
Yeah. 谁的话，谁的话都听不进去，整天就知道玩游戏。
And so I didn't want to listen to what they had to say, and I just wanted to play video games all the time.
我爸妈当时脾气也非常暴躁。
And my father also had a temper too.
我几乎每天都被骂。
I got yelled at pretty much every day.
一周也被打两到三次。
And I'd get spanked about 2 or 3 times each day.
但是还是不改变。
But I still wouldn't change.
在学校，我也是个不受老师和同学待见的学生。
So I wasn't always the best student and wasn't always the best one in class, even considered the best by my teachers.
但是在一个暑假时
，But during one vacation,
我在底特律的大伯，听说了我的消息。
I had an uncle who heard about my situation.
十分忧虑。
Oh, he was very worried about me.
于是每个星期都给我打电话聊天。
And he would call and wanting to talk to me.
他是来了美国20多年，十分虔诚的基督徒。
And he came, I think, to America 20 years ago and became a believer.
他没有骂我，没有劝我。
Now he didn't scold or argue with me.
只是给我讲圣经上的故事，类似于。今天的查经班。
And so he would tell me stories in the Bible, and it's almost like a Bible study.
他在我的心中是一个非常厉害的人物。
He's an amazing person in my life.
所以我每次都坚持听完，打完电话后，他还带我一起祷告。
So afterwards, you know, I'd always listen to everything he had to say, and we'd even pray at the very end.
就这样过去了半年。
And so this went on for about half a year.
我的情况还是没有改变。
But still nothing changed.
但是临近升学考试还有半年的时候。
When I still had about half a year left before I took that test.
我在一天偷偷的玩游戏的时候。
So I secretly started playing video games.
有个声音突然出现在我的脑海中。
All of a sudden a voice. I heard a voice.
你不能玩游戏了，你要去学习。
Stop playing video games and go study. You need to study.
自从这个声音出现后。
And so after I heard this voice.
我对游戏的兴趣就没有那么大了，有一种突然有一种改头换面重新做人的感觉。
So it was almost as if I didn't want to play after this voice. I didn't want to play video games and my interest for video games wasn't as good and almost I felt like a changed person already.
我的父母都很惊讶。
In fact, my parents were a little bit amazed.
我爸妈的脾气在那之后也就变得非常好了。
And my father's temper got a lot better too.
整个家庭变得非常和睦。
And our family started having more peace. We got along.
感谢神在我身上所做出的改变。
And praise God for changing my life.
还有一件事我一定要分享。
I wanted to share one more thing.
我的表妹现在在恩友堂接受洗礼，在同一时间。
I also have a friend that also accepted.
我的 cousin.
Oh, cousin, 表妹，表
妹。
Yeah.Also accepted Lord Jesus Christ as her Savior.
我想分享她一个简短的故事。
And I wanted to share something of hers.
在一个月前，她出了车祸。
About 一个月 one month ago, she got into a car accident.
她在那之前已经决志信主。
And at that point, she already decided to follow Christ.
当她出现车祸时，她当时非常紧张。
But when she got in the car accident, she was very nervous.
但是她当时就做出了祷告。
But she started praying at that time.
求主赐予我冷静，求主赐予我平安。
Please, God, protect me, give me peace,
and safe.
And keep me safe.
Yeah. 她在我心中一直是一个很不成熟的女孩。
And of course. You know, in my eyes, she wasn't always someone that I looked up to or followed.
但是她当时做出了一个非常理智的决定。
But at that time, she made a very important decision.
她拿起电话打了911。
She called 911 at that time.
然后打电话给了我。
And also called me.
感谢主，当时旁边就有一辆警车。
And fortunately, there were actually two police cars that were there.
警察询问了他的状况后，就把他送到了医院。
Oh, and they, after investigating and looking into the situation, they sent her to the hospital.
感谢主，他的骨头没有出问题，只是皮肤上出现了擦伤。
So her bones didn't break or didn't have any injury, but her skin had some injuries to it.
感谢主，让我在这里也可以照顾他。
And I'm very thankful that I can take care of her as well in the Lord.
不至于让他感受孤独。
What's lonely? And also to keep her from being lonely as well.
这就是我今天的故事。
And this is my story today.
感谢主降临在我身上的恩慈，让我生命变得如此美好。
And I'm just really thankful for Him, His blessing my life, and to allow me to have such a wonderful life right now.
感谢主从你而来的恩典、爱、安心和喜乐。
Thank Him for His grace, His peace, His love.And his happiness.
荣耀感恩归于主。
And all the glory and honor be to him.
Amen.
Amen.
Hello, my name is Justin Chen, and I'm 11 years old, and I go to sixth grade.I was born in Orlando, Florida, and grew up in Stephenville, Texas. I admit I'm a sinner. Sometimes I do things that are against God's commandments. For example, one time, my mom told me not to buy snacks during lunch at school. Well, the next day I bought snacks at school, and I went home telling mom that I didn't. After telling that lie, I felt really guilty. My mom and dad are Christians. When I was little, they took me to a church called First Baptist Church in Stephenville.But then I didn't know about Jesus yet. When I reached first grade, my Sunday school teacher started teaching me that Jesus died for our sins, and on the third day, he rose. Another way I came to faith is I went to winter retreat December 2016. At winter retreat, Pastor Byron talked to us during worship. He said a lot of things that influenced me to believe in Christ. For example, he told us that our private life is our real connection with God. This means if a person is out in public telling everyone that he is a follower of Christ and doing good things in God's name, but when this person goes home, he lives a sinful life and doesn't behave like a real Christian. I've never thought about this before, and I started to think about what a real Christian should do. This spring, my dad shared what Christian faith is all about and with me, and I prayed and accepted Jesus as my Savior. After getting baptized, I will go to Sunday school every Sunday morning. I will try to read the Bible every day. I will do my best to make good choices. I want to follow Jesus and live a good life. I will always put God first, and I will study the Bible more frequently. Studying the Bible will help me get to know more about Jesus Christ. Those are some things I will do after I get baptized. I have a prayer request, so you guys can pray for me if you want. Well, I'm in sixth grade, and we have lots of homework, projects, and assignments. The STAR test is coming up, and I want to be prepared for it. Lately, my grades have been going down a bit, and I'm a bit stressed out since when I get home, I have to do my school homework, then I have to do piano and Chinese homework and all that stuff. So I will very appreciate if you could pray for me to not be selfish when I'm really stressed. Thank you for listening to my baptism testimony. I hope you all have a wonderful day.
Hi. My name is Brittany Grant. I'm 16 years old and a junior at Plano Senior High School. Go Wildcats. I've been a Christian since I was really young. My mom was one of the children ministry leaders at church, and during service one day, the pastor was preaching about how we have all sinned and gone against God. But there was still hope because he let his son die on the cross for our sins. My mom asked me if I believed these things and if I wanted Jesus to be my savior too. We prayed together, and I asked Jesus to be my personal Lord and Savior. Accepting Christ has given me a greater purpose to live for. Knowing that my grades, popularity, or appearance, doesn't matter is so alleviating. It still amazes me that someone would love me so much that they give their life to save me. That being said, my life has been far from smooth sailing. One of my biggest struggles was when my mom passed away from cancer in 2009. I was so upset that I blamed my grief on God for letting her die, not only because she was my mom, but she was one of the key figures who brought me to faith. I went to church sporadically because I thought I was so devastated and angry at God. But in reality, God wasn't to blame for my suffering. I have learned that he didn't create suffering, but he will test us and use it for good. Romans 8:28 states, "And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose." My relationship with him has grown significantly throughout the years as we started going to this church. Through maturing my faith, I have learned even though you will face trials and difficulties, you won't go through them alone. Psalm 16:8 says, "I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken." This reminds me not to focus on myself, but on Christ, my struggles. He is my source of joy and the reason I can have such a positive outlook on my life, even in the worst times. My walk with Jesus is something that has been extremely important to me, and I want to tell the world about my faith. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello. My name is Elijah Gu, and I'm 12 years old, and I go to Robinson Middle School. I really like to play golf and spend a lot of time practicing almost every day. When I was younger, I didn't think much about Jesus and just came to church with my parents every Sunday. Once I got into youth and went to the winter retreat last year, things really changed in what I do with my actions. The guest speaker, Pastor Byron, really showed me the path to a close relationship with God. Once we came back to Plano, I started thinking hard, and I prayed for forgiveness and confessed that I was a sinner. That was when I committed to obeying God and accepting Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. I did this because I know that Jesus died for me on the cross, and I am a sinner. Because the Bible tells me that God shows his love to us no matter what, that even though we are sinners. I have some problem with emotion control, being humble, and respect, but I feel that now, because I know God is with me, I want to take the step of obedience and be baptized today. I have seen God do his works, helping me as I've seen him helping me on the golf course. After I had a bad hole and lost my temper a bit, I prayed and asked God to forgive me and stay with me. Then the next few holes, I controlled my emotions very well. Now, acting like a Christian, I can show that the Holy Spirit is inside of me. I will be attending the LA Envisions mission trip, and after that, I hope to tell many people about the Word of God. You can pray for me by making sure that I can keep my emotions and the Holy Spirit will dwell in me, and you can pray for me that I keep, I show respect to my parents and show a good attitude to everyone and stay humble. Thank you for your love and support.
Hi, my name is Ming Wong, and I'm 13, and I currently go to Rice Middle School. I came to know Jesus Christ when I was 3 years old. Our family just moved to Stephenville in 2016, and so my parents thought that we and my brother were ready to learn about Jesus Christ. And the church we went to was called First Baptist Church. And so I went there for 3 years, and I really enjoyed it over there. I can still remember the first time I heard about God, that there was a person like him, that he died on the cross for us to save us sinners. And I would always never miss a day, even if I was sick. But in 2 years, and I moved, and I was very sad. After moving around some, we finally came to Plano, and we went to PCAC here. I have been at this church for 5 years now, since the summer of second grade, and I've repented all my sins and accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior at the 2014 fall retreat. That was when I really wanted to start getting closer and wanting to learn and more about God. The purpose of me as baptized is not to brag or anything, but it's a step I'm ready to take. My baptism is a symbol of the gap that has been breached between God and me, made possible through the life and death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, my plan for these days, for now on, is to share my love of God through with my friends at school. And I have a few prayer requests. That includes praying for LA Envision team to prepare us well, and just pray that I can be a helpful missionary this year. And I also want to pray for my dad that he may consider to be baptized one day. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ping. I'm currently 13 in seventh grade, and I go to Rice Middle School. I have a twin brother who is younger than me. My family includes me, my brother, my dad, and my mom. The first time I can remember learning about Jesus was when I was three, when my parents brought me to First Baptist. At that time, I didn't know much about the only thing that I remember was how loving the workers of God were. I remember that my pastor showed me God's compassion to the Word of God. He shared the gospel to me, to everyone, and sometimes by having a one-on-one. Later, when I was at the PCAC Labor Day retreat, I committed to following Jesus Christ. In fifth grade, at retreat, I confessed my sins and put my faith in Jesus. I will follow God's command and not man's. I hope God will use me as a servant of His. I will plan to grow in God's way, but not on my own greed. I want to spread the word of God, whether it is at school, on a vacation, or even a mission trip. I hope that I will grow spiritually. I want to specifically help the unreached people about God, because one night, one of our pastor led us in an activity, and we talked about how many keep going, how we keep going to places that already have the gospel, but very few go to the places that have no access to the gospel. I want to make a stand for the unreached and let them become reached. I hope that you'll pray for me to be a faithful disciple of Jesus and to spread the word of God. I hope that you will help me through all of this.
Hi, my name is Gideon Wong, and I'm in the fourth grade at Evans Elementary in Allen. At church, I enjoy helping my daddy set up the elements for communion. I also enjoy making eternity bracelets for my daddy's and mommy's mission trips. On the weekends, I get to play golf with my aunt and uncle. I am blessed to have a close relationship with my family. After a mission trip, my mommy shared about Jesus. I realized that when I disobey mommy, I am really disobeying God. He wants us to listen and obey our parents. I am not perfect, and sometimes I still disobey my parents. But now I realize it's not right to do, and I ask for forgiveness. Mommy and Daddy always forgive me, just like God does. We needed forgiveness from our sins, so Jesus had to die on the cross. With His death, we can choose to be with God again. So I ask God for forgiveness and for Him to lead my life. Now I tell my friends about Jesus and teach them how they can pray to Him. I also know when I do anything wrong, I can ask Him to forgive me, and He will always forgive me. Please pray that I can learn to always obey my parents and listen to them.
My name is Maddie Wong. I'm in sixth grade at Mary Evans Elementary in Allen. I'll be going to my first mission trip in July with the youth group, and through preparing for the trip, I've realized it's time to get baptized. I enjoy being close to my family. I am blessed that I live close to my Aunt Mimi and my Uncle Kwani. I enjoy playing golf with them on the weekends. My parents are very involved in church and serving other people, and through that, I see how to serve God. Even though we all serve in the church, I know that we all make mistakes. Those mistakes are called sin. Sin is anything we do that doesn't follow God's commandments, like offending someone. Anytime I offend someone, my mom and dad always tell me to ask them for forgiveness. Forgiveness is important because it restores a relationship with that person. I realize that sometimes I offend God and need to ask for forgiveness. I know that I can never live a perfect life. Even today, I continue to make mistakes and sin. So that's why Jesus died on the cross, because I can never obey God perfectly. Only Jesus lived a perfect life, and only through His sacrifice we can have true restoration with God. That's why I prayed with my mom and gave my life to Jesus. I now know that even though I make mistakes, I would always be forgiven. I'm excited to go to LA and share with others the good news of Jesus Christ and help them realize the same thing. Please pray for me as I will be going on my first mission trip.
One more step. Okay, hold your hands here. Go further. Okay. Now I will ask you some questions. Ricardo, and you were raised in a Roman Catholic church.
Yes.
Do you still pray to Mother Mary now?
No, I don't.
She is not God, so you don't worship her anymore.
Correct.
Okay. And do you believe that Jesus Christ saved you from all the sins?
I do.
Now, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. 许清姐妹，我请问你，你上任主耶稣拯救你从所有罪过吗？
Yes.
你的罪过已经得到赦免。
Yes.
现在我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为你施浸，愿神赐福给你。 兰坤姐妹，现在在众人面前，我请问你，你相信主耶稣基督是你的救主吗？是的。他为你钉十字架，你的罪过，因为你接受他为你的救主，得到赦免了。是的。现在我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名，为你施浸，愿神赐福给你。 李刚弟兄，在众人面前，我请问你，你接受主耶稣为你的个人救主吗？是的。他为你的罪过被钉在十字架上，你的罪过已经赦免了。
对。所以你的一生是属于主耶稣基督的。嗯，对。你的一生不再属于油漆机了。啊，永远不会。
好，现在我奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名，为你施浸，愿神赐福给你。Justin。 Have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
Yes.
And do you know that your sins are forgiven?
Yes.
And now you are baptized in front of God and so many friends and relatives. Your baptism is a lifelong commitment. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. Now in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you. Brittany, may I ask you whether you have accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
Yes.
And do you know that your sins are forgiven?
Yes.
And your commitment before God and before so many people is a lifelong commitment. Is that right?
Yes.
Now, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you. Elijah, you get a great name. You like your name?
Yeah.
Good. You are the servant of God. And do you believe that Jesus Christ died for you?
Yes.
And because you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, your sins are all forgiven.
Yes.
And your commitment before God and so many people is lifelong.
Yes.
Now, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you. Don't be afraid. Okay. Have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
Yes.
Do you believe that because you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, your sins are all forgiven?
Yes.
And your commitment before God and so many people is lifelong?
Yes.
Now, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you. Pain. And have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
Yes.
And Jesus died for you on the cross?
Yes.
And your sins are all forgiven because you accept Him as your personal Savior?
Yes.
Now in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you. Gilead, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
And He died on the cross for you?
Yes.
And because you accept Him as your personal Savior, your sins are all forgiven?
Yes.
Now, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you. Medicine. Have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
Yes.
And do you believe that all your sins are forgiven because you accept Him as your personal Savior?
Yes.
And now you make a commitment before God and so many people. Your commitment is lifelong. Is that right?
Yes.
Now in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you. May God bless you.